Hey guys, welcome to another video, and I'm here with Rayan the Techwizard. And since a lot of people liked our last budget laptop video, we thought we'd give it another go. And speaking of, today we'll be unboxing another another budget laptop, budget gaming laptop, the Huawei Matebook D. Comes with Dolby Atmos. Cool. Costs around 800 bucks now, and it comes with some pretty decent specs, actually. Where's the specs sheet? Yeah, so it comes with 128 gigs plus 1 terabyte storage. Comes with 8 gigs of RAM and the NVIDIA MX150 chip and an i5 processor. So it's not bad. And I mean, it's a very obvious what Huawei is copying here, but I'll leave that up to you guys, you know, whether you like the design or not. So unlike a certain fruit company where we're getting single ports, we still have a couple of ports here, an HDMI port and a headphone jack. Hey. So Ryan, you ready to unbox this heavy box?
Yep, it's too heavy. Yeah, I think I'm not gonna get up the list.
Oh, let's try it. Right, so just peel that up. Wow. Okay, that's interesting packaging. Oh my god, it's heavier than it looks. Let's put that to the side for a second. What else comes inside the box? It's a charge brick.
Charge brick?
Yeah. It comes with very much looks like Apple's charge brick.
It's
a basic charger, not USB Type-C, and a Chinese manual.
Oh,
strange. Stickers, let's get that in there. Doesn't come with anything else, does it?
This, inside this, it's Arabic for some
Oh yeah, reason. There's multiple language. Okay, so that's cool. At least there's a... Anything else inside the box?
Let's see if there's anything else.
Okay. Right, so let's just pull that out of the sleeve. Careful, it's a little heavy.
Oh, Huawei.
Huawei.
That's her.
Pure aluminum, that's pretty cool. I was thinking maybe it'd be plastic.
Oh, another bag thing?
Yeah, it looks a lot like a certain other company's keyboard, huh? And that's a nice feeling trackpad, I guess. And it's solid brushed aluminum all over. Let's see, so it has anything else on the side? It has another USB port on the side.
Three USB ports?
So three USBs and a full-size HDMI, power port. Okay, so right off the bat, I can tell you that this laptop is very, very smooth. I mean, the performance is excellent.
And look at this.
No, what do you call it? The processor, which is the i5-8250U processor. It's handling everything else really well. We've been downloading some stuff, you know, just getting it set up and everything, and so far, we have not even experienced a single hiccup, and it's quite a smooth experience. The only thing is, though, that button, it's just a button in this model, because it's the budget member of the family, or should we say the cheapest one, it's just a button. The rest of the family, or if you go, you know, one step higher in this same model, with the i7, it comes with a fingerprint. This one just doesn't. So about the sound quality, it does have Dolby Atmos as advertised, but the problem is that the speakers are underneath the body, right? I guess they couldn't fit in anywhere else, so they're underneath. And while there are, you know, there's a few rubber pads to lift it up a little bit, but it's strange that they would position them at the bottom. They kind of sound tinny because of that, but here, we'll give you a sound test. Click it.
At least, and it's also the first phone here officially to support a teardrop notch.
Not that we're fans of notches,
but what you gonna do? This is at about 70% audio volume, so let's see. It does get pretty loud. And there is a good level of bass.
What's wrong with it? Does it look like a live slime?
It does get loud, and it does sound decent enough. Not the greatest bass ever. It does sound good. But the problem is that the sound is going downwards. And if you're in an environment where there's a lot of noise, the sound gets muffled. So there's that. So the 8 gigs of RAM, they're soldered in. You can't actually change anything. In fact, you can't remove the battery. You can't access the hard drive. Everything's soldered in. So good luck trying to upgrade it. You get what you pay for, I guess. But it's all in all, it's a pretty decent configuration. And well, we'll see if we do a gaming video test of this or not. But so far, we're quite impressed with everything that's on offer from this $800 laptop. So Rayan really seems to love the trackpad because it's like glass. And also it has Windows Precision Driver, so that's pretty cool. So it is quite thin, you know, that's pretty cool. I like that it's a thin body. And it's all aluminum top and bottom. The only thing is, here's the fan, along with the speakers. So the charger that comes with the laptop, right? It has about 3.4 ampere charging speed, and it does a pretty good job at charging it fast. I'd say it charges around 1.5 hour from zero to full. That's pretty cool, and pretty fast too. Yeah, that's just the charging plug we get in this region, Middle East and all. So, the Matebook D, right? It's a really, you know, a decent laptop for most people. It's a budget gaming laptop. And we tried a couple of basic games on it and they worked smooth. There was no hiccups or anything. Then again, we'd have to do a deep gaming test to, you know, really push this guy to its limits. But from what we've tried, very, very decent laptop. And for $800, and that's, I guess, because it's now discounted. There's probably a new one coming out soon. But it's not a bad laptop. And for $800, you can do worse. So, right out the bat, huh? Two thumbs up. Two thumbs up from us.